I bought my children goldfish the other day. You know, that little gold ones? I put it in a glass bowl for them to enjoy in the house. Now, my daughter was really specifically excited about these goldfish, really taking care of them. And they went to school, and that day when I came into the living room, one of the fish has died. Now, this specific day, my daughter was going to compete in a competition that she has been preparing for the past few months. And I didn't want her to be upset. Now, I know we need to teach them about life and death and how to cope with that, but this wasn't a day I wanted to teach her that. So I quickly ran outside, because we have a fish pond outside with the same goldfish. So I took out one and I quickly threw it into the bowl so that she won't notice one of the fish has died when she comes back from school. And she didn't. When we returned from the competition, all the fish has died. Every single one of them in that little bowl. I was so upset. My daughter was upset. And my husband asked me, why was I so upset? Because I told him I didn't want the fish to die. I told him the whole story, what I did. And he said, Natasha, you realize that when you take out the fish and the fish was sick in a bowl, the water became toxic. So the environment was toxic. So that's why all the rest of the fish has died. So you don't treat the fish by taking the fish out. You need to treat the environment. Today, I'm going to talk about E for environment in our Let's Explain series A to Z, everything a parent needs to know about love, sex, and dating when it comes to their kids. Now, we don't treat the sick fish, we treat the water, we treat the environment. Are you listening today to this video because your son has been exposed to pornography or your daughter has been sexting? You can't change your child's behavior without changing the environment. Your little fish is swimming in a toxic environment. Be aware of your child's surroundings. That is the water that they are swimming in. So you want to change their behavior. Obviously, I haven't found a mother or a father wanting their daughter to text, keep on sexting, or wanting their son to watch pornography. So you want to change that behavior. You need to help your kids by setting them up for success. We set our kids up for failure by placing them back in this toxic environment. So let me help you look at today how your child's environment or surroundings are supporting their behavior and not helping them to change. Most of the children that I work with, I haven't found one that said, I don't want to change, I want to continue sexting. Normally the children I've been working with, they don't want to do that. So they need help and we need to set them up for success. So let's look at our kids' environment and what I found, there's four environment triggers that actually support children to continue with sexting and pornography or masturbating. So let me help you today to see how your child's environment look like, and maybe you can be challenged today to go and make some changes in your child's environment. So these are the things that they are busy with most of the time, or when I ask where's that triggers, most kids would masturbate when they are in the shower or in the bathroom, or when they're taking a bath. A lot of girls would actually be playing around in the bathroom. Now you say, Natasha, that's not true. Well, it is. I've been talking to enough kids to hear when they are doing it, because I help them not to be placed in that situation that triggers to continue doing this. Help your kids by limiting their time in the bathroom by taking showers. So what I do in my house is I make sure as I am getting dinner right, starting to finish up and putting it on the table, I would tell my son to go for a shower. He doesn't even know this. He would quickly need to go for a shower, because in that little period of time, he needs to be quick, because the food will be ready. You're just helping them gently, changing that environment so that they are not tempted to go and play in the bathroom. The second one is don't leave your teenager home alone for a long period of time with nothing to do. I work with teenager boys, and when they have the opportunity to go and watch pornography, if they have been exposed in the past, they use these home alone opportunities to go and search that out again. So don't leave them home alone if it's not needed. Let them drive with you. They will say, oh, it's boring. That is good shoulder to shoulder time for them to talk with you or just be with you. And even if they're upset, you can give them some chore that they can do with you. Don't leave your child home alone for a long period of time, especially your teenagers. That is the time they're busy with things like that. Otherwise, if you have to leave them, make sure the Wi-Fi is turned off or things like that. The third one, no devices in the room. Now, this is quite challenging, especially when I bring this up. Your teenager has been used to for their phones to be charged in their rooms and devices being in their rooms. This is just the extra temptation in the environment that creates more toxicity in the environment. No devices in the room. And I want to challenge you as parents. Are your devices in the room? Our devices is not in the room. We have a charging station in our study. All our devices, including me and my husband's devices, are not in the rooms. So take it out there, take away that toxic environment that you are creating there for them to be tempted. The fourth one is they are bored. When they are bored and they don't have anything to do and they have electronic devices, they're going to start looking for things that they're not supposed to. You get your child involved in activities, healthy activities, sporting activity, culture activities, music lessons, whatever they enjoy. Make sure they are busy. Don't leave them alone with doing nothing. And I do know we need to give our child just to be free and don't have all these hectic schedules. I'm just talking about just being at home doing nothing. We should give them free play time to do some fun things, but then obviously that should be outside or in an environment that is fun, not all alone at home bored with a cell phone. Okay, so you would say, Natasha, I trust my child. He knows what's right and wrong. Why should I take all these precautions? Now I want to quote you Philippians 3 verse 3, and it says, do not put any confidence in the flesh. If you have a teenager in your house, do not put any confidence in the flesh. Their hormones are going to tempt them to look for things that they are not supposed to be busy with. And when there is devices, they would get involved with things that they are not supposed to. So even if they know it's not right, and even if you have told them don't do this, their flesh will be tempted. So help them, set them up for success. Help them not to be in this toxic environment. I want to challenge you today. This is hard, this is not easy. But if you want your child to change this behavior of watching pornography or sexting and things like that, you need to help your child, empower your child by not just fixing or treating the fish, your child, but also changing the environment. What are you going to do today to help your child by changing their environment?